What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose in an interview you were given an array of points where points of I is an array of two numbers representing the x and y coordinates of a point on the xy plane. Given an integer k, you are asked to return the k closest points to the origin O, O. As a reminder, the distance between two points on the xy plane is the Euclidean distance, i.e. square root of x1 minus x2 squared plus y1 minus y2 squared. And since we are dealing with the origin, this equation can be simplified to the one next to it. The uniqueness of the answer is also guaranteed. Okay, before diving into the implementation, let's attempt to visualize it by drawing an xy plane with several points on it. As you can see, and based on the Euclidean distance calculated for each of the points, if we had k equals 3, let's say, these three points will be the closest to the origin and the result we are looking for. Now, the first trivial solution that comes to mind is traverse the list of points and calculate for each given point its distance to the origin. Then, after doing that, we can sort these distances and map each distance to its corresponding point and return the answer. Take note of that squared distance helper method, as we will be using it in all our implementations. Another way to write this solution is by making use of streams and object-oriented programming. To do that, we can go ahead and create a point class encapsulating the distance and the index of that point. Then we will proceed exactly like we mentioned. We will start by looping over the list of given points, then we will map this two-dimensional array to a stream of the point class we just created. After that, we will sort that stream with the help of the distance attribute in ascending order and retrieve the first k points of that stream. Then, with the help of the index attribute, we will map the point objects retrieved to their initial two-dimensional array. And finally, we will return the resulting array. This is a valid solution, and even if it is not optimal, most interviewers might find it enough. However, we are not most interviewers, so let's try to further optimize the solution. You see, the thought process is correct. We need to calculate the Euclidean distance and store it somewhere, and the points to return are the ones with the smallest distance. But the improvement that can be made is instead of doing these steps sequentially on all the given points, we need to find a way to do them simultaneously, and every time we calculate a new distance, directly update the k points to return. If you've been watching the previous videos of the series, you may have guessed by now that one way to achieve that is by making use of priority queues. So, instead of storing these points in a map, we will store them in a priority queue. And when we attempt to poll or remove a point from this queue, we expect the farthest point or the point with the maximum distance to be removed. Why? Well, suppose we have this queue of three distances, each corresponding to a point. When we attempt to add an additional point with distance 5, we can note that this new point is closer to the origin than the farthest one marked in red, right? So, the logical step would be to poll or remove the farthest point from that queue and then add this new point. These three points are now the result to return the closest k equals 3 points to the origin. Okay, after creating the queue, the rest of the logic is straightforward. We will loop over the points and create a point object, similarly to what we did before. Then, after filling the queue with the first k points, we will start checking if the following points are closer to the origin than the farthest point stored in the queue is. If that is the case, as we mentioned, we will poll the farthest point and add the point we just created to the queue instead. After looping over all the points, the queue will contain the closest k points. So, all that is left is mapping these points to their original two-dimensional array with the help of the index attribute. This is done by polling all elements from the queue and storing them in a new array before returning it, and that's it. A link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.